It's Madden NFL 23, where we'll get a rematch of the first ever Super Bowl. It's the Green Bay Packers and the Kansas City Chiefs, next on EA Sports.
It is a beautiful night for football here in the Midwest as we are at GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, Missouri.
Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Green Bay Packers and the Kansas City Chiefs. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Set to go in a rematch of what would come to be known later as the first Super Bowl. The Chiefs and Packers are underway.
Taken in at the three. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. And here comes the winner of the last two NFL MVP awards, Aaron Rodgers, as he brings his Packers out for their first series of the game.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
Rodgers going to the air to start things out.
And this is caught by Watkins. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a second and one forthcoming. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
On second down, it's Jones. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver. But it's going to be second down. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. He gets it forward for 4, maybe 5, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back.
So that run play nullified by the holding call on the tight end.
Yeah, I just think he needs to get off the ball a lot quicker and get into the block a little bit more effectively. Then he doesn't have to reach and grab and try and hold on.
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Flushed out right. And this will be incomplete.
Oh, I saw this one with defensive eyes because even as he escaped the pocket and bought time, the coverage stayed tight. Nothing broke down. Throwing it away, that was his only option.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Escaping the pressure right. Let's it fly deep for Cobb. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted.
Picked off by Legarius Sneed.
And he'll get it all the way down inside the 35-yard line.
Well, they certainly weren't afraid to let it fly early, and they hope that'll keep the defense honest and keep the offensive guys excited about getting back out there. They are in attack mode in this game. It did backfire a little bit. Now you're just hoping your defense can keep them off the scoreboard so you're not facing a deficit the next time you run out there.
Here comes the Kansas City offense, and in his sixth season of conducting this high-powered attack, coming off four straight Pro Bowls, it's Patrick Mahomes.
And when you think of Patrick Mahomes, you start to think about all of his attributes, and you realize very quickly, you can't just put him into one box. No matter how the game proceeds, no matter what is needed, he tends to have an answer for it and plays accordingly.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. So after the INT, here's Mahomes. And this one caught. And now a fumble. The ball's out. I'll call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you maintain possession, that's all you're looking for.
First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. They'll run with Edwards-Helaire.
And a nice pick up there. He gets about five down to the 4-yard line. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yes, now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
Second and goal from inside the 5. Again, Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Clyde Edwards-Helaire taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Chiefs take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown.
Well, CD, there didn't seem to be much resistance there down near the goal line.
Yeah, partner, from what I saw there, not a real good job of matching up defensively because to me, they looked like they were just in their base 3-4 package. You need bigger bodies in there in a goal line type situation. The 3-4 fine between the 20s, but not down here when you're guarding your end zone.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And his kick is good to make it 7-0 KC. Scoring summary, 3-play drive. And it's capped off by a touchdown run from Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10.
They'll begin the drive with a run by Dillon. They'll get this to the 24, and it's second down.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
From the 24, Rodgers. That'll be complete to Alan Lazard. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down.
Alan Lazard just keeps improving season by season, and he's become a favorite of quarterback Aaron Rodgers. This year needs to be his biggest jump yet because the Packers need someone to step up and replace Devontae Adams. Looked a little bit like Adams on that catch, moving the sticks.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Rodgers going to throw. And Lazard's got it again. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And it's second down.
Oh, I see you nodding your head along with me, partner, because it's pretty obvious what they were trying to do there on the drag route. With his speed, they're hoping he can turn the corner and maybe take this to the house. But that was excellent work defensively to make sure once he caught it, he wasn't going anywhere.
On the delay, Jones. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say we're going to build from the inside out because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He has it complete to Christian Watson. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 43. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one, the man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 43. Here's Rodgers to throw. Under a heavy rush and down he goes. They overload him that time with a safety blitz and he winds up being dropped for a loss of 7.
So that time, Charles, a quarterback helpless really in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly.
Yeah, that's one where you turn to your lineman and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely because remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
From the shotgun, a give to Jones. It'll be a gain of about 5, but they're left with a third and still about 12 to go. See what they have drawn up here a little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. To throw is Rodgers. And that is incomplete. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. And this punt sails over the sideline. And the spot, it looks to be right at the 25-yard line. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They've got the 7-0 lead. Now they've got the football back after their defense got the stop, CD. And you get the feeling if they could score here, they'd really have all the momentum on their side.
And you just wonder right now, is the quarterback and the play caller totally in sync? Are they of one mind that, hey, what worked last time? Let's keep doing it until they stop us. Or do they go to a different section in the playbook, show them something different? Either way, they want a repeat of their first drive.
First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards. He's settling in nicely here in the first quarter running the football. Remember, he already has the touchdown run.
And you can feel the vibe, can't you? He's in unison with his offensive front. They are in concert together. So if you're flipping over to the other side of the line of scrimmage, they've got to be more physical and handle some of these gaps that have been created.
Right back to Edwards-Helaire on first down.
And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter from Arrowhead. It's the Chiefs in possession as they've got it with a second and one coming up. Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep. 2 yards, good enough for a first. Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. On second down, a run with Edwards-Helaire. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 41 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times.
Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. Look at that nice little drive brewing right here.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Mahomes on the give to Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one good for 12 yards and a Kansas City first.
Well, they continue to run the football this strong right up the middle. I don't know if they can wait till halftime to make adjustments. They better find a way to get it done series to series. I don't know if they need to sub some guys out, bring in extra people, maybe change what they're doing on the defensive side of the ball. But right now, they're running the ball very well right at them and right up the middle.
On first down, Mahomes. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster, complete. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. So 8 yards on the completion there, and they'll be left with second and a couple. Mahomes going to throw. Gets this into the hands of Gray, the tight end. And they're going to be set up now with the ball at the 13-yard line.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. They go back to the ground with Edwards-Helaire. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. On the tackle that time, Dean Lowry. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Mahomes to throw on second down. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes hitting his favorite target, Travis Kelce, on the touchdown pass. And the Chiefs go up by two touchdowns.
Another impressive drive. So they're two for two, two touchdowns. Charles, a great start to this ball game for them.
And one of the words that's really worked its way into our lexicon is stacking. They've stacked momentum each time out, not only on offense. Between those touchdowns, defense held, forced a punt to get the ball back, and they've played awfully well in this one. Both sides playing at optimum level.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that'll make the score 14-0. After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And now this offense comes back out onto the field.
And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now, if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action, make it look like the same exact play, and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Got a man. That's Lazard. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. An inside give to Jones. And he's got this down to the 35. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. A beautiful fake. And he'll be brought down with the first down after a gain of about 11 as that takes us to the 2-minute warning. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
This is a half where not just the coverage, but the entire defense is setting the tone in this game.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. To throw, it's Rodgers. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones.
They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four.
Boy, that one was well read defensively. And this is all about diagnosis as a safety and being decisive, because he saw it setting up in front of him, able to knife through there and make the play.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Eluding the pressure right. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. What can't Aaron Rodgers do? The legwork there getting him the first.
Oh, man. Just when the D thought they had the answer for him, he went and changed the question. Surprises him by taking off himself. He's able to set up his offense pretty with a first and goal.
This is first and goal, and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Throwing now is Rodgers. Touchdown, Packers! Sammy Watkins, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Packers get a late score here, the final minute of the first half.
Yeah, you heard it, right?
Exhale.
You heard the exhale, and I'm taking that from their bench, because finally, right before the half, they find a way to get the ball in the end zone and get some points on the board. Maybe they can use that to kickstart them for the second half.
Yeah, just to get something before going into the lockers. And now in the second half, they can just tighten.
That's what they want to do, tighten down everything they're doing, and then maybe explode at the right time.
Crosby connects on the extra point, and that'll make our score 14-7. For the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the five. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. Well, in the process of that kick return, it appears we had an injury. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Mahomes now to throw. He'll get this one to Kelce. That's complete. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now here's Mahomes. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Dean Lowry just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7.
He seemed to have a reasonable amount of time in the pocket, but he couldn't get rid of the football, and the end result, Charles, him on the ground.
Yeah, he's got to keep an internal clock to go along with his offensive line. When you're talking about 3, 4, 5 seconds, that's a reasonable amount of time to expect to deliver the ball downfield. So great to try and complete a pass, but it's equally important to know when to throw the football away too.
The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes to the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. Nifty running there, but it'll come on what should be the final play of half number one. So we've come upon halftime here in KC with the Chiefs on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, BG, thanks very much. And welcome one and all to our beautiful new downtown Orlando studios for this EA Sports Halftime Report. First up, though, a look at the next-gen stats for the Packers in that first half. And they did not do much at all in terms of throwing the football in those first two quarters. That's going to need to improve if they want to erase this deficit.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. For the start of the third quarter, the Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. McCole Hardman to return it from his end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Second half starts with a run by Edwards-Helaire. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. To throw, it's Mahomes. He'll find Clyde Edwards-Helaire. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 27 yards there, a first down.
Boy, a lot of moving parts on this play, but what a nice design to leak the running back out to the left and send him down the field. And a good job spotting him and hitting him for a big play.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes, and he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Edwards-Helaire as they run out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. Big Kenny Clark that time pushing upfield to make the tackle for loss.
An awful lot of congestion in the middle third of the field, but how about our defensive tackle right there? He didn't just hold the line. He provided some push and smacked the ball carrier down for a loss.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. A shotgun snap and a give to Edwards-Helaire. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Throwing now is Mahomes. That to his running back, Edwards-Helaire. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. Butker's kick here is good, and they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they've been moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
To the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. So here are the Packers now. They get set for their first possession of half number two. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 18. And he'll begin the drive with a give to Jones. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. 50 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now Rodgers. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it's second down. Now Rodgers. He'll find Jones again, complete. Short completion, just 4 yards, and that'll leave him with a third and 2. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And this will be a Packers first down as good running gets him to about the 44.
The duo of Aaron Jones and A.J. Dillon split the work in Green Bay last season. Jones was still his excellent self with almost 1,400 all-purpose yards and 10 touchdowns. He even moved into the all-time top five for the Pack in rushing. No small feat with that franchise's history.
A pair of first downs gives him a first and 10 up at the 44. Rodgers going to give this one to Dillon. And a good pickup there. He gets about six up to midfield.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
On the counter, here's Jones. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Give him 18 on that play, and Green Bay has the first as well. Aaron Jones, you know, not one of the bigger backs in the league, 5'9", 208, but he's definitely what you'd call a downhill runner. And he's able to shed the tacklers there for good yardage.
And as a former defender, I can tell you with certainty, those are the ones that have you losing sleep at night. I would not like to be in that film room on Tuesday going over that one. Just a pretty poor effort defensively, and it leads to a big play.
And the next-gen stat shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. When we call them run fits, everyone was in the right place.
Here's Watkins on the jet sweep, and he is going to lose yardage here. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play backwards a yard.
Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. We're back now in KC. It's the Packers who have the football, but in need of points as we begin quarter number 4. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Coverage was awfully tight there on 3rd down. They actually closed off all the passing lanes, forcing the incompletion and bringing up 4th down.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This will be spotted at the 37, so it's a 47-yard attempt. The kick by Crosby is good, and they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. Well, no field goal attempts for him until the final quarter, but no hesitation on his end. He comes right out and nails his first field goal try.
I give him a lot of credit, too, because he stood there the entire ball game, but has managed to stay with it both mentally and physically. When they called on him, he was ready, and he knocked it through the posts.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties.
Hardman going to bring it out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. And the Chiefs offense ready to go again. The field goal we just saw has this now at a 1-score game. And on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous, a little stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking the pulse right now? Might be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball. But here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose as opposed to playing to win. And they've got to get back to that. And that means opening things up again, being a little more free in what they're trying.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. So a pick six there out of the nickel package. They went with five DBs.
Almost becoming the base package in the NFL is the nickel. Hard to throw against. That was demonstrated one more time. A pick six going the other way.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. Seventeen the score. All even to this point as the kick's away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. And Kansas City's offense now set and ready to go. They will look to flush the memory of that pick six as we now have a brand new tie ball game here in the fourth quarter. Getting down to the good stuff. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. The drive will begin with a run by Edwards-Helaire. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Snap will come from the 31 on second and 7. Mahomes going to leave it with Edwards-Helaire on the draw. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you. And others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
The frustration evident there because he couldn't find anyone on third down, and he left no doubt that he was throwing that one away.
Here's the Chiefs punter now as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10.
Green Bay's offense ready to go again. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at the 31-yard line. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he'll get this up only to about the 33.
Chris Jones, the all-pro defensive tackle, there to make the play defensively.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times. And what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle ended up making the play.
Here's Jones again on second down.
4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. now to throw. Able to find Lazard. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Rodgers teaming up with Lazard there for a Packer first down.
Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. They'll go again to Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you get success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. Throwing is Rodgers on 3rd down. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds.
The Chiefs offense set to go. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10 at their own 27. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Complete, the tight end Kelce. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave them with a 2nd and just a few inches left. They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And that's going to be a Chiefs first down as the tackle made it about the 43-yard line.
The Chiefs value what Edwards-Helaire brings to a backfield group, both as a runner and a receiver. Average over 60 all-purpose yards per game for them across 10 contests. They know he can produce even more if he can stay healthy for the full season.
And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the 2-minute warning.
1st and 10, it's Edwards-Helaire with it.
And he'll be tackled right on the midfield logo.
72 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got a 2nd down now as they search for a score to break this tie.
They'll set up the screen to Edwards-Helaire.
And he is going to lose yardage here. They'll wind up losing 3 here on the play. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now.
Short gain last 2 plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely, this defense, they're saying go right ahead with those. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also 3rd down.
Here's Mahomes. Finding Edwards-Helaire once again. And he will have a Chiefs 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Mahomes. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it here with a minute 7 remaining. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now a carry for Edwards-Helaire. And he is going to lose yardage here. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7. Mahomes on the give to Edwards-Helaire. And he is going to be stopped at the 12, short of the first down. Call it a gain of 5. 4th down now. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to take the lead here in the final minute. Butker's kick here is good. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. And you know, in an era of cost-cutting and maximizing your roster, this is a club that does not skimp on special teams, and in these situations, it pays dividends.
And that's great vision by the organization. When the difference between winning or losing depends on who you have kicking the ball, would you rather have a street free agent out there or a solid pro like this? Answer's pretty evident to me.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the 5. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. The defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. 1st and 10. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A fun, close ball game comes to an end. On that last play, Charles, they were on the wrong side of midfield. They needed something near a miracle, and they couldn't get it done.
Yeah, the effort, that was good. Very good, in fact. They were just a little too far out to get a decent look at the end zone for that last opportunity. Couldn't get it done, but a nice game overall.